Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the Cabir Symbian OS Worm. This was the first piece of mobile phone malware, which originated in the middle of June 2004. Now bear with me as these displays keep going blank. I'm going to have to keep waking them up a little bit here, but we're going to send the worm over from my PC to the first phone you see on the left. And yes, we will receive that. All right. Got one new message. Wonder who it's from. Application is untrusted and may have problems. Install only if you trust the provider. Yes. I trust me. Install Carib. So this is the name the author intended for this worm, but antivirus firms don't like to give authors the recognition they want, and instead opt to rename the malware to something similar, or in this case, sort of rearrange and drop some letters. So let's say yes, I want to install Carib. And there's no certificate, of course, and details, Symbian OS version 1, not installed. Let's fix that, install. So this one just kind of hangs up once it runs, but Cabir has now infected this phone. There we go, we see Carib, and there we go. Now we see a message on the right-hand phone. Receive message from Bluetooth from Nokia 6600. So as you might have guessed, that is the worm sending itself. And what it does is it picks one other phone in the vicinity that has Bluetooth discovery enabled and tries to send itself to it. And if we say no, because I don't know who this is, and just wait for a bit, we're gonna see what happens. And here we see about 30 seconds later, another pop-up. Receive message. No, I still don't know you, so I'm going to say no. And once again, about 30 seconds later, like clockwork, Cabir tries to send itself once again. So eventually, you get fed up and you say, all right, fine, receive the message. So it sends itself on over. Show. And just like the last one, we're going to install Carib, say yes, and install. There we go, we see Carib, and we've received carib.sys, and now this phone has picked up another new potential victim in the area. So do we want to receive it from the third phone? Of course we do, yes. And show. And this is how Cabir works. It picks one phone in the vicinity and sends itself over and over until the user eventually relents or leaves the area. So you either get out of Bluetooth range of the infected phone or you finally allow it to send the message to you. Either way, it's a bit annoying and persistent, which is what helped it to spread in the wild back in 2004. And Cabir actually formed the basis for many other, well not many other, but a few other worms. You can see on the left I've been trying a few different variants, and none of them are particularly interesting. This first one here is really the best one that I found as far as functionality and simplicity, and it just works right for a video. Oh, app closed BT server. I guess our Bluetooth connection was closed. Well, that's fun. But like I was saying, this first A variant, the original one from 2004, is really just the best one I found to make a video on. And when you're on this Carib screen, nothing really works until you hit end and get out of the app. So again, 2G networks are dead, so these can't find a tower to attempt to verify their SIM card, which doesn't work anyway, which is why you see that message. That's not related to Cabir. And removal of this particular worm is not too bad. We're gonna restart this phone here on the right. We're going to watch the usually buggy boot up sequence. It usually cannot get the full song out without stuttering and breaking up. Kind of reminiscent of phone calls from that era. So ding, that's all you get. It's usually supposed to play this nice little tune, but not anymore, I guess. What are we doing? What is happening? Oh, hey. Okay, I've never seen that before. Cabir actually ran itself when we started the phone. So normally it was pretty easy to remove because you just restart and then go into your little application manager and get out of it. But in this case, it's booting up, so that makes it a little more difficult to remove. There were a variety of antivirus tools created to remove Cabir from phones and their eventual variants. So it's not too much of a threat. It's not destructive to your data like something like the Skulls Trojan or Bootton. But it is notable for being the first piece of mobile phone malware. And from images I've seen, it is supposed to display the author's credit when this screen here is shown with the Caree puzzle piece. I've never been able to see that message actually show up, but I just wanted you to be aware that it exists. And this was written by a member of 29A, a notorious VX group from the 90s and mid-2000s, who wrote a lot of impressive and otherwise technically complicated and novel stuff, in this case, the first piece of mobile phone malware. Just an interesting little tidbit for you. And that is about it for the Cabir Symbian OS Worm. Thank you very much for watching. Take care.